said.
I'm looking for a queen.
At least 10,000 years replied and begged to be the royal bride. However, in the end, he chose a lady called Miss McCoy, who brought along a curious toy that seemed to give her endless joy. This was a mirror framed in brass, a magic talking-looking glass.
Ask it something, day or night, it always got the answer right. For instance, if you were to say,
"Oh, mirror, what for like today?"
the thing would answer in a trice.
Today it's brown legs and rice.
Now, every day, we keep the spoiled and stupid queen of chat.
Oh, mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the first of them all?
The mirror answered every time.
Oh, madame, you are the queen sublime.
For 10 whole years, the silly queen repeated this absurdity. Then, suddenly, one awful day, she heard the magic mirror say,
"From now on, queen, you're number two. Snow White is prettier than you."
She called the huntsman to her study. She shouted at him,
"Listen, buddy, you took this filthy girl outside, and see, you take her for a ride. Then slit your ribs apart and bring me back her bleeding heart."
The huntsman dragged the lovely child deep, deep into the forest wild. The knife was hot, the arm was strong. Snow White cried,
"I've done no wrong."
The huntsman's heart began to flutter. It melted like a pound of butter. He murmured, "Okay, bad kid." And you can bet your life she did. Later, the huntsman made a stop within the local butcher's shop. And there he bought, for safety's sake, a bull's heart and one instead.
He cried out,
"Bravissimo, I trust you killed her nice and slow."
Then, this is the disgusting part. The queen sat down and ate the heart. I only hope she cooked it well, but the heart can be as tough as hell. While all this was going on, oh where did Snow White gone? She got a job unpaid, a general cook and maid, with 7 funny little men, if not more than 3 foot 10. Who had one shocking vice, they wasted all of their resources at the risk of causes. When they hadn't got a winner, none of them got any dinner.
One evening, Snow White said,
"Look here, I think I've got a great idea. Just leave it all to me, okay? And no more gobbling till I say."
That very night, when there was no tide, young Snow White hitched another ride. And then, when it was very late, she slipped in through the palace gate, on tiptoe through the mighty hall, and brought the mirror off the wall. As soon as she had got it home, she told the senior dwarf, or gnome, to ask it what she wished to know.
"Go on,"
she shouted.
"Have a go,"
he said.
"Oh, mirror, please don't joke. Each of us is Tony Brook. Which horse will win tomorrow's race? The Ascot Gold Cup steeplechase?"
The mirror whispered sweet and low,
"The horse's name is Mistletoe."
The dwarfs were absolutely daft. They kissed young Snow White here and there, then dressed her up to bring some money here. With which to better Mistletoe, they went to Ascot and, of course, for once they bagged the winning horse. Thereafter, every single day, the mirror made the bookies pay. Each dwarf and Snow White got a share, and it was soon a millionaire. With souls and goblins not